that's where I'm going.
Yeah, they got on the street there and you can see, I don't know what to do.
For the summer to come just means I get to thrash around the bush for a few months. We're brush cutters, which is synonymous with a variety of other catch names, such as slasher, thinner, brusher, tree killer, forest weeder, tree farmer, maniac with saw, and in French, la débroussailleur. It's a fascinating world to be part of, and it rides through the core of my soul, bridging the constant unrestrained perspectives of reality. Patches of jungle of young boreal trees and overgrown brush awaiting our presence to selectively thin it. Each tree roughly 1.5 meters apart, clearing everything in between, making a chessboard-like facelift if viewed from above. Though from the moment it's been spaced, it immediately starts growing like a headful of hair, sometimes demanding a return a few years later to keep it maintained. The job itself, the actual cutting down of the young trees, the willful determination to push yourself physically past what you once thought was humanly possible, and then shattering your own limitations again and again, constantly hungering towards the next challenge, exceeding your own self-constructed barriers of limitation. A study analyzing our heart rates and our physical output on the job confirmed indeed what we do in a 4-hour day an Olympic athlete does in 8 hours of training, and burning 4,000 calories a day for our efforts is not uncommon. Good times, good people, in short, encapsulates what the bush is all about. Our tribal meetings usually consist of getting high and conversing about the daily happenings, revelations, stories, jokes, always shrouded in humor, prompting us to eagerly await tomorrow's ritualistic gathering. And unfazed by the dire troubles of the world, we reacquaint ourselves with nature, reaping the spiritual benefits of solitude and togetherness.
Yeah.
Cogs in the machine, we acknowledge that. We're still compared to bumbling around in a cubicle in an office somewhere. The bush life brings a peace of mind that the greatest of Zen masters would appreciate. The daily submergence into the depths of one mind turns into a form of meditation as the body consciously switches to autopilot, then exerting its internal drive to defy its temporary notion of physical limitation. Into the whirlpool, the mind sinks gracefully unscathed by the swirling debris of mindless chatter, drifting through an ocean of expanded awareness, accessing the source of intuitive insight. If this is what it means to be a murderous savage, I plead guilty and stand proud of it.
Oh no! Oh no! He's jammed! He's jammed! He's okay! He's okay!
Paul inspecting his guard.
Guard inspection.
Now, everybody should do this at least twice a day before you start and at the end.
Take it off. Start by taking it off the saw.
We'll just zoom in here.
The guard,
yeah.
Off the saw.
You must.
The guard inspection. There's 1, 2, 3, 4 holes here.
That's how you know it's a 480.
It's getting a little bit worn. Paint's coming off here. Yeah, I don't know.
Did you modify it at all? Like make it better?
No, I haven't modified it. So it got worn here from the sticks. The sticks getting caught in it.
This happens frequently.
Yes, the sticks. Yes, but I'm not liking the way this look. I don't think it's good to go today.
You got a lighter, Paul.
Not good to go today. Well, let's check out here. You kind of
You grind this down, hey? That looks nice.
Yeah. So the, when I want to like take it off, because you don't want to spend all day taking off your guard for a guard inspection.
Right.
This way I can just jam a stick in there, and whenever I need to inspect it, I can just take it right off.
Right. And then it looks perfectly natural.
Well, there, my guard is on.
No one's going to put that on.
I can cut fine with that.
That's definitely passes the inspection. Good job, Paul.